everybody. How are you doing tonight? I'm Sammy Shore. Yes! And this is my jazz together. Are you enjoying it? I've got a partner in crime. I'm going to bring him up here in just a moment. First, I was telling the folks last night, if you were here, I explained that I've aged a little bit over time. I'm talking glasses now. Allow me to thank our wonderful sponsors. This is a community effort. It's a community event. And we're delighted to have District 7 from Shy Family Wines. Thanks so much for supporting us. I hope you're enjoying this tonight. I know I'm having a little right after this. Decibel Brewery, thank you so much for your support. You're a new partner with us, and we absolutely love you guys. It's a brand new Monterey. Big thanks to Kim DiBenedetto Fine Estates. You guys have been wonderful. I'd like to thank the Dawson Cole Fine Art Gallery. That's the home of the Richard McDonald sculptures that you're seeing to my right and left. And all over Quail Lodge this weekend. It's wonderful working with Michelle and everybody over at Dawson Cole. Big thanks to Heather Downs from Downs and McNeil Wealth Management of Merrill Lynch for delighted to have you on board again this year. Heidi Studio Carmel, thank you so much for keeping us well coiffed. Your support. The Cheese Shop in Carmel helped us out at the wine line today. Who was at the wine line? Wasn't that amazing out in Carmel Valley? We tried District 7 wines, and we tried Joyce Vineyards, and as well as Testarossa, and we enjoyed cheeses from the Cheese Shop. It was fantastic, and chocolates from Lulu. Our media sponsors are smoothjazz.com Global. Without them, we wouldn't be here. Thank you. KSPW-TV8. Carmel Magazine, Monterey County Weekly, you guys have been great, and Jazz's Magazine, as well as the Monterey Jazz Festival. They have they came to me this year and asked if they could support us, and we said thank you, yes. We love Monterey Jazz. Tomorrow we have a brunch with David Sunshine and David Benoit, as well as the Nathan East Trio featuring his son Noah, and that is going to be amazing. We still have a handful of tickets left for that. Please allow me to introduce to you a gentleman who is considered to be one of the most recorded basses in the world on over 3,000, by now probably 4,000, since this morning, let's make it 5,000 recordings. He started one of the most, probably the most successful contemporary jazz ensembles of all time. He is a very dear friend. I love him to pieces. Please welcome Nathan East to the stage.
What an honor it is to be here in such a beautiful location, part of the world. We've been all over, everywhere, and I think there are not very many places on this planet as pretty as Carmel.
There's one other location that we'll be going to in 2021. We have a special announcement for you tonight. Those who were here last night already know the cat's out of the bag. We are going to Tahiti, and guess who we're taking with us? All of you, exactly, and three others. We have a long list coming, but this is just a start. I'll let you tell us who's coming with you.
Well, I have to say, since our beloved Chuck Lowe passed away, Foreplay has not done much, just in honor of him and in respect, but we will be reunited for the Tahiti cruise, original format. Lee Ritenour, Bob Ben, Charlie Manson, and myself. So Foreplay will be there for our first time back.
Something. I mean, that is really something. And we're doing a special offer this weekend. We haven't announced that yet on the internet or anywhere else, but here in Carmel this weekend. And we're offering a special incentive rate. The introductory rates, they do include airfare from San Francisco and Tahiti, and to Tahiti from San Francisco or LA. And it's all inclusive, the whole cruise. I mean, everything you like, all the good stuff, it's all included. And you'll also, whoever books here will get the front row VIP seats. We'll reserve it in your name. So go see Norm and everybody at the front desk afterwards. Listen, I want to bring up another friend of ours. We mentioned Monterey Jazz earlier. I'd love to bring up the director, Colleen Bailey, who's going to give us a little sneak peek of what's coming this year at Monterey. Again, no one knows this yet. This is insider stuff.
Stuff. And first of all, I just am so pleased to support Sandy and what she's doing with this great jazz weekender. So please give her a big round of applause. much jazz happening in this area, and like you said, it's a beautiful place to be, and we want to bring you back for a couple of big events. So the first one is in April, the first weekend in April, April 3rd through 5th, we have an event called the Next Generation Jazz Festival, where we feature some of the most talented young students who are coming from middle school and high schools from across the nation, down at the Conference Center in Monterey. And you can't think of these people as being like students. You close your eyes and you think you're, you know, listening to professional musicians. They're absolutely incredible. And they're competing for the opportunity to come back to Monterey Jazz Festival to play for the large audience that we have in September. So it's a phenomenal event, 3-day festival, April 3 through 5. We'd love to see you back in this area for that. And then, of course, September, fourth weekend in September, 2020.
So what year is it for you guys?
The 63rd annual. Right, 63rd. So we are the longest continuously running jazz festival in the world. Thank you. And really, really proud to still be the gold standard in traditional jazz festivals. And we have 500 artists coming over 3 days during the festival. And you're the first to hear this. We will be honoring Pat Metheny this year as our jazz legend. Phenomenal. We'll be bringing back Buddy Guy, who's a blues legend. And this year we're doing something to honor Clint Eastwood, who is a legend that I think everybody in the world knows. He's been on our board for many, many years, and he turns 90 years old this year. And he's done more than almost any other person to make sure that jazz is alive in the film industry. And so we'll be honoring what he's done over the last 25 years to bring jazz to the film industry. So we'll do a tribute to him and to his films and to his music live on stage on Saturday night at a festival. So that just gives you a sneak peek. We go on sale April 1st, and our website is montereyjazzfestival.org. So I hope to see you all back in Monterey County for that. Thank you, Sandy.
We'll have a class of District 7 in just a second. I want to bring up the band now. It's a stellar band. I mean, it's a one-of-a-kind experience. And before I do that, my nephew was supposed to be here with us tonight, and I would like to dedicate this show to him tonight. He couldn't make it. To Micah. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a man who's known for his arrangements, his compositions, his incredible keyboard playing. He's a fabulous human being. Greg Fillinghames. Please come and sit. There he is. It's an honor to have you. Up next, we've got the taller but younger brother, also a bassist. Welcome to the stage, James East. James East, also an amazing bassist. One of the family. Oh, I love the hat. And this gentleman is, you know, he's incredible. He's played on so many albums over the years. I could better to tell you what he hasn't played for, from Cher to Celine Dion and Barbra Streisand, Eric Clapton, everyone. This is Michael Thompson. including his own band, the Michael Thompson Band. You may remember that. On the drums, from the United Kingdom, he played with Dire Straits, Average White Band, and he is a heartbreaker, musically and in real life. The one and only Stephen Ferrani. Come on up. Come on up. There, I want to remind you there will be a signing after the show tonight. It'll be right across the room in the Oak Room, and the guys will be over there, as well as any artist who's in the house, and there's a lot of them. They'll be over as well signing, and we've got a nice step and repeat, big logos. You can take your picture with these guys as well. We'll look forward to that. And then the after party with the world's most dangerous after party band, the Pete Project. That's tonight. Don't miss it. They have special cocktails. Of course, we've got the Dust Bowl Brewery beers and District 7 wines. I had a Jazzerita last night. Nathan had a Jazzerita last night. It was fabulous. Do join us after this event. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the Nathan East Band.
Thank you. break this room to him yesterday. Come on, man.
I think I'll redeem myself from that.
Since we're going to be reuniting the band, Foreplay, I thought we'd do one of the songs that Foreplay plays. And this is actually about James' composition that Love plays, Always Tender Lady.
Everybody's saying things like this. Come on. So you can feel a little happy when you're in a jazz club. Come on. Thank you.
Thank you.
Night Stadium on drums, Steve Veroni. Come on. From the average white band.
Thank you.
By the way, when Greg was 15 years old, he got a call to play with Stevie Wonder's.
19.
Little story.
Okay, so a little story. I'm from Detroit. I always dreamed of playing with Stevie Wonder when I was a kid. I had pictures of him on my bedroom wall and the whole thing. And a friend of mine, a dear drummer, was asked to audition for him in New York. So the night before we left, I went to his house, obviously very excited. And he insisted that I play some things on cassette. And he would take the cassette and give it to Steve. So he goes the next day. Some time passed, a few days, and then my friend calls me early in the morning and says, Stevie Wonder wants to see you in New York today. What do you do? So I needless to say, I'm packing like a banshee and I'm running around the house. My mom was on her way to work. She says, what are you doing, boy? Is it my Stevie Wonder with Stevie Wonder? She says, well, just bring me an underwear. Because you know when you're a kid, that's all your mother cares about. She don't care what you're doing. You know, you can be dead on the street. First thing she's gonna ask, did he have any, there were no tracks, right? Did he have any? So I go, I get my stuff, you know, I go to New York and,
I'm there, man, and I go to New York, and when I land, it's just like,
New York, just like the picture. Skyscrapers and everything, you know? So I go there, and I get settled, in the hotel, I go to the studio, and I'm waiting on pins and needles, hours go by, and finally the elevator door opens up, and here led by my sister, and they say, Stephen, the kid's here, so he comes up to me, and he says, hi, and that single handshake changed my life. So we did some songs on there. And so the next day I auditioned, you know, it was more of the formal audition with the band, and I ended up getting the gig, but, interestingly enough, my friend did not get it. No, he didn't get it. He ended up with Roy Ayers, who was hanging around at the time, and then our paths crossed. Sometime later, he ended up being with Stevie and Phil Collins and a bunch of other people. And the only bad thing about this, the only sad thing about this, is that I have to say his name in the past tense because he was the dear, beautiful Ricky Lawson. That was my friend. But thanks to him, I got the. So, give it up for Ricky Lawson real quick. Yeah, I know.
That's amazing.
Yeah, I just have people, other musicians go, I didn't know that. Yeah, it was pretty amazing. And it was just before my 19th birthday, but guess what? It was just before his 25th. Stevie Wonder was 25, and he was working on what? Songs in the Key of Life. Yeah. So it was literally a kid hiring another kid to be in his band. And I'll leave you with this. I'm on four songs on Songs in the Key of Life. On four songs. So one of them is Saturn. You know. Going back to Saturn weather. Thank you.
Super Bowl because he arranged the opening theme of America the Beautiful that Yolanda Adams sang. There's another thing that Greg's done, arrangement that I really love, and I'd like to see if we can ask him to play it for one of our people that's in the audience tonight who's celebrating his 71st birthday tonight. And I think Stephen Isaacs is in the house somewhere. Anyway, all the way from there you go, from San Francisco, so happy birthday. And I think we have just for you this special Greg Billy Gaines version of
Yeah, this is what I do to all my friends. I call them up and I you know, when they pick up, I do this.
Thank you. Thank you. that's one of the iconic pop tunes written in the last, that's like a Gershwin tune. I think the whole title, Human Nature, is a very, very poignant and bittersweet one. And so I implore all of us in this time to search and find and look for and go with our higher angels. Okay, I recently cleaned the screen on this thing. I think it's gonna work. Pulled it out of the doctor's bag there. Sandy was giving me a hard time last night. It's like, what the fuck? What is it with you and the doctor's bag? I had the pleasure of playing for a few years, actually, with the first jazz LP I ever owned, I think, was one of the very first ones I remember buying at the Jazz Record Revival on South Broadway in the jazz mecca of Denver, Colorado. was by a very young man, and I loved this record. It had on it this jazz, contemporary jazz chestnut. The record was by a guy named Earl Clue. Right? I didn't know. Life is amazing. I didn't know that years later I'd get to play with Earl and have him record on this. Actually, I did a new version of this. This was a tune I always loved as a kid, and it's been funny, right? Because a lot of the things I've loved as a kid, I love to this minute, you know? So it's pretty interesting, from Joni Mitchell to the Beatles, to James Taylor, to Earl Clue and Cannonball Adderley, all of it, right? So we're going to play this tune, and man, it's just in honor and thanks for everything. And this is, thank you guys for coming out and listening. I hope you're having fun. Me and Greg are going to do a little thing at the beginning. We don't even know what's going to happen. It's going to be an improvisation. And then we're going to go into this. This is Earl Clue's Vonetta. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'd like to introduce the band. This is a little band that we put together here. We found these guys in Carmel. We think they're very good. They're local, and for those of you who live here, you can see them in Moss Landing. Phil's Fish House on Thursday nights. They have a regular gig. You might want to check them out. They support the local guys. We think they have a future. That's Steve Ferrani over there. That man. Billy Hemp. That's Michael Thompson, my new buddy. What a guy. One of the contemporary jazz greats of all time, Greg Fillinganes on piano. How about that? Round of applause for our musical director, Nathan East.
Nelson Rangel, come on.
Well, all right, everything has a beginning and a middle and an end, and we played a lot of different kind of music for you guys, so thank you for listening. And we're going to finish out with a tune of mine and some of my buddies, too numerous to mention. So I'll just take credit for it. It works for me. So it's good. All right, this tune was thanks to Sandy and all sorts of nice folks. And I actually talked quite a bit with Sandy about this tune. I said, you know, Sam. And she said, you don't know. And then I said, sand. No. And it went like that. So, this tune is something called Tidal Wave, and it did very well on the radio, I'm happy to say. And, you know, happy about that. And Art Good. We've all heard of that man. I like him very much. Thank you. And he called this his track of the year for 2019. Okay. I'll take it. Number one is number one. That's good. All right. So this one we're going to finish up. We've gone from Sonora to this crazy monstrosity. This is called Tidal Wave. And it sure has been a nice playing for you guys.
One, two, three.
That's the man, Jeff. Come on.
Hey!
Dave Cross?
Definitely Dave Cross.
But didn't we have the winner of the Dave Cross Look-Like Contest earlier today?
But that's not him.
Oh,
that was Dave.
Wow.
Yeah.
How about that?
You know, he just came to play on that song.
He's on.
Going back to Sausage.
He's in the car. He's in the car. He's out. See, that's how the big boys do it.
Dave Cross just doesn't care. That was not a fig newton of your imagination.
What?
Wasn't that fun?
See,
you have no idea that the things
that
are going to happen
here.
Imagine. Are you guys watching Black Mirror, by the way?
Yeah.
Just check it.
Please.
I have no life. I just watch everything on everything. You guys know everything is on everything now, all right? Everything's on Netflix, Amazon, Xfinity.
Yeah.
Who else we got? But there's so much good stuff. I can't, you know, I can never leave my bedroom. I go from my bedroom to you guys. So you know why I talk so crazy. So we're going to do a few songs that you might know. I like to call this next tune the medley of my hit, and here we go. Well, at least I had one, damn it.
Thank you.
Jones' goddaughter, by the way.
You wouldn't believe the things I had to do to get him to say that. It's only your goddaughter once.
Well, he really is. One fine day in the 80s, we were in a studio with your godfather.
Yeah.
And there was a beautiful song that was being recorded for the first time.
Oh, do you want to know like the full dirt on that song?
Yes.
So did everybody see Best Friends? Of course not, because it didn't do anything. Thank God that you're the one. Best Friends was a movie that starred Burt Reynolds and Goldie Hawn. And they were chosen to make this movie together because, alas, they were both the number one box office attraction in the world. So, of course, the picture company said, so they got them together, and they did Todd, and they made their movie. And then somebody said, oops, we need a theme. So they couldn't find anybody really cool, so they got Alan Marilyn Bergen to write lyrics and Michelle Grant to write a song. And the whole idea is that I was going to sing this song in the body of the movie. That's exactly where I was going. Yeah. Exactly where I was going. And you don't even play saxophone. You know, the last guy that I let walk in front of me, he had to play saxophone. You can't do that to me. I'm a senior citizen. I'll lose my train of thought in 2 seconds.
He said me too.
You want to hook up later? Maybe we'll forget about it by tomorrow. So anyway. So they wrote this song for me to sing in the body of the movie in a scene right after Bert and Goldie, who were living together, went to meet their potential in-laws, and it's like a nightmare. And they get on one of those people movers, and they're kind of like this, gulled like this. You just finish fighting, having a big argument, and he's about 20 feet ahead. And she slowly goes by, the chorus of the song gently comes in. That was supposed to be it. We finished the recording, and Marilyn Bergman said to Alan and to, who was our director?
Sid wasn't sitting with it. Oh, I can't think of his name.
I think it was Sidney Pollack. Anyway, she went to the director and said, you know, this song needs to be the closing title for the movie, and we need to get, this needs to be a duet. And Patty and James just came off like a huge duet hit, the medley of my head. And so, so we have to put them together. We've got to get James in here. And so somebody got on the phone, and we discovered that James was in Tokyo. But he was coming back the next day. But we had time constraints because the movie was getting ready to come out, and this was a last-minute decision. So James flew back the next day. He came into the studio, and he was righteously exhausted. And he'd never heard the song before. Played the song for him a couple of times. He looked at the lyrics. So let's sit down. So we're in the booth, we sat on the floor. And I said, could you guys bring the mics to us? We're not standing up. James is sleepy, and he's making me sleepy just looking at his ass. So they took the mics, and literally, we sat up and leaned up against the wall.
Did they really put the mics down?
Yeah, they lowered the mics, they lowered the boom, and we sang the song through one time. And we finished the vocals, and we looked at each other, and we were both crying. And of course, we both manned up. Okay, let's do it again. Did it again. We did it in 3 takes, cried every time, and the rest is history. And then, of course, the song was nominated for an Oscar. And of course, because I had very bad karma, we lost to a crustacean. You're wondering to yourself, how is this possible? Well, when you're up against Bastard crab.
Once again, I was called the N-word. A nominee.
Ah, see? See?
Immediately assume. So, yeah, we lost. But I think our song is better. Is anybody running around singing under the sea now? No, they are not. Everybody wants to claim this frickin' song. Well, it's mine, damn it, it's mine! Okay, let's do it now that I've said it up so delicately.
Yeah. award-winning, should've been winning song.
And if we can do that.
each other, we would have come to a really cool sweet spot.
Right.
So, in keeping with that thought, and in keeping with the sweet spot, we've got a lot of crazy stuff going on in the world. And there is one thing that I know that can dissolve crazy and hate and nonsense, or as my friends in China say, nonsense. You are into a lot of nonsense in your country. I work in China a lot too. All the, you know, all of these so-called third world countries love me. I don't know what it means, but there's a chance I could change some minds along the way. But one thing that is constant is this thing that we're all kind of here for this weekend, this Valentine's Day thing. The foundation of it is love.
Yeah.
So years ago, I got to work with this guy that wrote really cool songs, and his name is Bert Bacharach. And I think he wrote the greatest love song ever. So I give you this for your heart, for your soul.
Yeah!
What the world needs now, you know your part, is love.